Well, it's tax-free weekend, and that means it's going to be busy for back-to-school shoppers. And we know the hardest part is knowing what's tax-free and what isn't. Now, Stephanie, you took some time to check it out for us.
I did. We headed over to Target today to take a look at some of the items that you may have on your back-to-school list. It is tax-free weekend this weekend, starting tomorrow and running through Sunday the 17th. So as you're heading out this weekend, we wanted to give you some ideas about some of the things that you'll be able to get tax-free and some that you'll still have to pay taxes on. Let's start with some of the items that you're going to get tax-free this year. You'll be able to get all of your kids' back-to-school clothes and all adult clothes as well tax-free. And that does include undergarments. So as you're doing your back-to-school shopping, all of those items will be tax-free. Also new this year are belts. You can get belts tax-free. Now if you buy a buckle on its own, you will have to pay taxes on that, but you can get your back-to-school belts tax-free this year. Also, athletic shoes. If your student needs new shoes, most athletic shoes are on the tax-free list. Also, cowboy boots are on the tax-free list this year. Here's the big one, backpacks for your students. These are tax-free, but they have to be school-type backpacks. So if you're buying a camping-type backpack, it probably is not going to be tax-free, so keep that in mind as you make those choices. Some of the items, most importantly, that you will be paying taxes on this year. Your athletic bag, your gym bags for your athletes. If you need a new gym bag, you will have to pay taxes on those, so keep that in mind. Also, things like gloves for your sports, baseball gloves, you will have to pay taxes on. And any cleat, any shoe with a cleat, soccer, baseball, football, all of those shoes you will have to pay taxes on. Here's a big one for parents of little girls. All your headbands, your bows, your barrettes, all of those are probably on your back to school list, and those you will have to pay taxes on as well. Don't want to forget about the teachers, our teachers, your briefcases, your purses, all of those things you will have to pay taxes on. Sorry about that. But as you're loading up your basket this weekend, you're probably going to have items like movies and personal hygiene items. You will have to pay taxes on those as well, so keep that in mind. Some of the big ticket items that most people hope they could get tax-free still are not tax-free. Your electronics, you cannot get TVs, VCRs, MP3 players or cameras. None of those items are tax-free. Here's the big one, back to school, your school supplies. All of your school supplies, you do have to pay taxes on. So keep that in mind as you're doing your shopping. For an average family shopping, spending about $100, you'll save about $8 for every $100 that you spend. So as you're calculating in your head, again, $8 for every $100 that you spend. But we hope this helps you as you're shopping on your tax-free weekend for back to school. In Odessa, Stephanie Rivas, CBS 7 News.